This is your Bible Geeks Daily Download, cross-training, Battle Cat Courage. Growing up watching TV in the 80s, my friends and I imagined we, like scrawny Prince Adam, could thrust our sword in the air, shout, and transform into He-Man. But He-Man had a sidekick, Cringer, who needed a transformation of his own. His green and orange feline friend was scared of his own shadow until He-Man turned him into the fearless Battle Cat with a bolt from his sword. And if you've ever felt frightened like Cringer, maybe you too need a bolt of courage from above.
We're cross-training to develop our integrity, one of 12 marks of the master we're working on this year. Integrity comes when we receive the whole truth, live with purity, develop our character, and speak courageously. So how does Christ transform us from cowardly to courageous in this dark world?
Here's what you need to know. If someone saves a child from a burning building, we rightly call them a hero. But the hero might ask, what other choice did I have? I couldn't walk by and ignore the situation. What looks like courage on the outside often feels like a necessity on the inside. The Lord's people often describe that same feeling of responsibility to speak, even when it's uncomfortable. For necessity is laid upon me. Woe to me if I do not preach the gospel, says Paul in 1 Corinthians 9, verse 16. Jeremiah felt the same, saying, if I say, I will not mention him or speak any more in his name, there is in my heart as it were a burning fire shut up in my bones, and I am weary with holding it in, and I cannot. Jeremiah 20, verse 9. In the same way, knowing the fear of the Lord, we persuade others as the love of Christ controls us. 2 Corinthians 5, verses 11 and 14. As a watchman on a city wall, if we don't warn of danger, that's on us. Who are we if we don't love people enough to speak up?
What's the measure of a true friend? Why does the Bible declare faithful the wounds of a friend? Proverbs 27, verse 6. Because you can count on your real friends to tell you what you need to hear, not just what you want to hear. We can get all this twisted and cut people off for speaking uncomfortable words. At times we might have to say with Paul, have I then become your enemy by telling you the truth? Galatians 4:16. Biblical love doesn't seek a friend's short-term happiness at all costs. Love does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. 1 Corinthians 13. Verses 4 and 6. We can't control a person's response, but we try to believe the best and know that our service to God is never meaningless.
God's people have a history of boldness in the face of uncomfortable and even dangerous circumstances. From Stephen's convicting sermon to Esther's royal requests, from Barnabas advocating for Saul to Paul opposing Peter, from Joshua's choose this day to Nathan's you are the man. May we join the long line of courageous saints who stepped up and spoke up.
And here's what you need to do. Think before you speak. Know your heart. Are you responding from bitter anger or genuine concern? We can mistake courageous speaking for rash speaking, loud speaking, or harsh speaking. We can't go around looking for conflict, but we won't pretend there's peace without God either. By speaking the truth in love, we seek to build people up, not tear them down. When we tame our tongue, we can direct it to offer wise, purposeful words. Every time we say anything in Christ's name, we soberly speak as one who speaks oracles of God, 1 Peter 4:11, taking care in what we say and how we say it.
Read the room, considering the impact that your words will have. Maybe it's best to speak up publicly, or perhaps it's better to address it privately. Consider how you would want someone to approach you in a difficult conversation, and make sure it fits the occasion.
Once you've prepared yourself, speak up. Though it'd be easier to stay quiet, if anyone is caught in any transgression, you who are spiritual should restore him in a spirit of gentleness. Keep watch on yourself, lest you too be tempted. Galatians 6:1.
So how can we speak courageously through the week? Here's five challenges that you can do on your own, along with us.
First, we invite you to read Matthew 10, 26 to 40, Acts 4, 13 to 31, Colossians 4, 2 through 6, Jeremiah 1, 6 through 19, and Ezekiel 3, 17 to 21.
And then we'll reflect together on a spiritual question, asking ourselves, what makes me shrink back from confrontational conversations?
And then we'll make our request to God, praying, God, give me a spirit of power, love, and self-control.
And then we challenge you to respond by initiating contact with someone today to offer encouragement, pointing to Christ.
Finally, we encourage you to reach out by asking someone, what impact have the courageous words of others made on your life?
So let's speak up with boldness this week. And may the Lord bless you and keep you today.
Shalom.